I wrote Bridge to Terabithia because I couldn't do anything else. Our son's best friend, who was a girl, was struck and killed by lightning when they were both 8 years old. The previous spring, I had been diagnosed with cancer, so my children were already upset. And then Lisa was killed, and it was a mess. And of course, if I could have done anything I wanted to do, I would have brought Lisa back from the dead. But I couldn't do that, and I couldn't even comfort my son, who was totally distraught. So I did what writers often do when they can't do what they really want to do. They write a story to try to make sense of something that doesn't make sense. And you know that a story has to make sense. You have a beginning and a middle and an end, and when you get to the end informs the beginning and the middle. And it's not that it's an intellectual argument, but emotionally something has happened. So that's why I began to write the book. And people always want me to say that it comforted my son, but no, it was really for me. People are always asking me about my favorite books. And, well, of course, you always think of the books you read or were read to you when you were tiny, all of A.A. Milne and Beatrix Potter and Kenneth Graham and Robert Louis Stevenson's poetry and those things, which were very much a part of my childhood. There's so many wonderful writers for little children. I had a wonderful experience with my older granddaughter when she was tiny. She'd gotten into some kind of a snit when they were visiting us, and her father exiled her to the living room, and her mother came in and said, "Mom, I think that Katherine needs a visit to the Bunny Planet." And, you know, The Bunny Planet by Rosemary Wells, it's a wonderful book that a child who is in trouble, there's such a comfort. And I know my own children loved Whistle for Willie by Ezra Jack Keats. And Vera Williams does wonderful books for little children, I think, because they have such heart and such understanding for the heart of a child. There's a book by Stephen Kellogg called Best Friends, which is wonderful about the difficulties you have with your best friend. But the best books are not just about problems, they're about a child's heart. And Charlotte Zolotow is another person who knows truly how a very small child feels and is able to translate that into a beautiful story. Well, my great advice to people, either who want to have readers in their family or writers in their family, is read. Read to them. Read with them. I was very fortunate. My mother read to us from birth, and that's when I learned to love books. In fact, I cannot remember when I learned to read for myself, because it was such a natural process. It was just like people talked to me in two languages. I learned to speak in two languages. People read to me all the time. I learned to read. So I say to children who are always saying, "What advice do you have for young writers?" I say, read, because that's the way you learn how the language works. That's the way you learn about emotion on paper. That's where you find out how stories are fastened, by reading and reading and reading, and you just absorb it. Nobody's giving you rules and working it out. You're learning, and you're enjoying it while you're learning, which is very important.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Ann B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.